Hi everyone, this is Professor Kim in cat mode today, and I'm making a really quick video about how to find the quality factor for an RLC circuit. Because when I was going through some problems, I realized that it was surprisingly hard for me to understand where this came from, but then once I figured it out, surprisingly easy. So let's go through it. First of all, what are we even talking about? We're talking about RLC circuits. It could be anything with, so I'm gonna say with R's, what's an R, a C, and an L, an inductor, in some combination of a circuit. It could be in series, parallel, some combination, there could be multiple. So some circuit with those things. This is only for second order systems. I'm assuming that you already know how to get that into the transfer function. So once we do that, we have some sort of transfer function, H of S. And if it's a second order system, that means that we're gonna have some sort of form. And the numerator, I'm gonna put numerator of S. There's some polynomial of S. Maybe it's a constant, maybe it's second order or whatever. The bottom though can be put into this form. This is kind of a standard form. And from previous lessons about these circuits, you may be familiar with the damping factor, and I am terrible with this. That's a zeta. And then we have omega naught here times S plus an omega naught squared here. So you may be familiar with this form that we can put second order systems into this form, and then we have some coefficients for that. Another way that this can be written is the same, essentially the same, but we can write it focusing on a different, like the kind of the flip of the damping factor, which is the zeta here, and it's actually the Q factor. So it's going to be written omega naught over Q times S, and then plus a constant omega naught squared. For reference, this is the damping ratio, and then the Q is the quality factor. And first, I want to just explicitly write the relationship between these, because once you have it in this form, it's actually pretty easy, because we have an omega naught in each of these, and so these can be equated. These are just kind of two standard forms to write it, and it tells us kind of different things about the system. But if we rewrite this over here, we see that 2 zeta omega naught, that coefficient has to be equal to omega naught over Q. And if we cancel some stuff out, we can see that I'm gonna write it in terms of the quality factor first. So quality factor, move that over, move that down, is equal to 1/2 times the damping factor. All right, so this is a relationship that you can just kind of remember. So damping factor, I think, is a little bit easier to understand. It's like, how much is the system damped? So it's like reducing the, attenuating the system. And then the quality factor is the inverse of that. So a higher quality actually means it's gonna be less damped. Okay, so that's one relationship that you can remember right there. So now how do I go from my system to figuring out the Q factor? So let's say I have a specific transfer function. So we'll name it H1. And I'm gonna make it simple. Let's say the numerator is just a 1. And I have a second order system. I solve my circuit, and then I have it in the form of like some numerator, a squared plus bs plus c. So it's, as you derive, usually you'll get it to this kind of polynomial form. And so I wanna figure out what is the quality factor from that. The first thing we need to do is put it into standard form. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna divide both sides by A. So we want to get the coefficient here to be 1. So I gotta divide both sides by A. I always write this out just so I reduce my chances of making mistakes, which I make a lot. So B over A, S plus C over A. Great. And then just for completeness, remember, there is going to be 1 on the top two, so you do have to do both the numerator and the denominator to put in the standard form. Great. So now we have this in this form, and essentially all we have to do is equate the coefficients here. So I'm going to write step one is find the omega naught, is find omega naught, find omega naught. So step one, we're going to find omega naught. And so to do that, you can see that this term can just be equated to this, and you can solve for omega naught. So make omega naught squared equals C over A. Then you take the square root of both sides. Sorry about that. Destroyed that two there. And usually, even if you have plus minus, it's usually going to be the plus in all real systems. So we would just, for example, have the plus. I'll just put that there. Okay, so you find omega naught. Great. And so now you have that value. Now step two is going to be to find the Q value. So pretty much we know that this term has to equal this term. So you just equate those numbers together. And we have, oh, so find Q. So we have the B over A here. That is equal to omega naught over Q. And so you could then plug this into here. If you really want me to do it, I'll do it. I was just going to tell you to solve for it, but we can do it. Q equals A over B. And then we have our omega naught value. So it's going to be the square root of C over A. And in this case, we can simplify. We can cancel out the square root of A on top and the bottom. So we get Q equals 1 over B times the square root of A here and C. So this is the Q value for the specific coefficients of our original denominator in the transfer function. To summarize, if you want to find the quality factor for an RLC circuit, you need to first find the transfer function of whatever you're looking for. You've defined your inputs and outputs, and then put it into a standard form. So solve the circuit, put it in polynomial form, and then put it into the form with the coefficient of 1 at the front, 1 here, and then compare it to the standard form here and equate the two values. So first equate the constant value and solve for omega naught, and then equate the second coefficient here with the S, and then use your omega naught you just solved for, and then equate them together and solve for your Q value, and that will give you the accurate Q value every single time for your RLC circuit.